How did a country that used to look like this now have one of the best recycling systems in the world? If you want a glimpse of what the future of plastic recycling looks like, this might be it. Each little robot is sifting through 55 pieces of garbage per minute, and it's not humans running the machine here, it's AI. But Taiwan is also a huge plastics consumer and manufacturer. Just head to a night market or walk around anywhere.
We're a poster child of that plastic pollution.
The country is no longer swamped with trash like it was in the 90s, so it's obviously doing some things right. We went to Taipei to see for ourselves just how it's done. And within hours of being there, I discovered that something pretty important was missing.
So I just had my little snack, and look how much waste I already produced.
But I couldn't find any public trash bins to put it in. Turns out the city removed thousands of them about a decade ago. Why? Because in Taiwan, you have to pay for any waste that can't be recycled. The whole point is to make people responsible for minimizing the amount of trash that goes into incinerators. Everyone holds on to their own garbage, and these iconic cars come around to pick it up 5 days a week. It's a whole Taipei ritual. This way, people can't cheat and throw their private waste in public bins to avoid the fees. And they're not shy about getting shame involved. It's a pretty intense recycling culture that places a lot of the burden on individuals. But it's part of the policy structure that has gotten Taiwan in the top ranking in Asia for its waste recovery rate in last year's Environmental Performance Index. Although it also has its flaws. But I wondered what happens after the supposedly recyclable trash gets picked up. So what did I do? Got on one of these myself, of course.
Ready, go.
These trucks belong to a private company, Dafon, just one of the many businesses the government works with to collect, sort, and regenerate waste.
Not a lot of traffic, weather's really nice.
These companies get subsidies from a centralized recycling management fund. Their pay is guaranteed, so even if global plastic prices drop, recyclers are protected.
Okay. Smelling, starting to smell a little bit. So this is the stuff we're gonna pick up. This is all residential plastic waste.
This centralized national fund that directly subsidizes recycling is what sets Taiwan apart from other countries. Who pays into this recycling fund? Producers and importers, so the policy also keeps manufacturers responsible for their plastic footprint from the get-go.
Oh my God, it stinks. So much milk.
And it makes it easy and profitable for businesses to get into the recycling game.
Recycling is great, but I am getting heat stroke.
To cool off, we went to another plant to hang out with some special robots who have one of the most important jobs in the industry.
Hello!
Hi!
Welcome!
Beina!
Nice to meet you!
I'm Jenny!
Hi, Beina!
Welcome to our AI sorting robotic center!
Whoa! Trash! What are these toys here? What's going on?
This is kind of like a little trinket they do, because toys cannot be recycled, actually.
Wait, why can't they be recycled?
So, like, for example, this, right? So there's a cushion inside, it's cotton. You cannot recycle cotton.
Okay, good to know. Yeah. Toys.
And it is cute, too. Save me!
The plant processes 40 to 50 tons of household recyclables every day. The AI sorting arms identify 17 types, from plastics and metals to paper.
Okay, so is this the celebrity AI?
Yep. This is the famous celebrity arm that you
see. And like, how much faster is the robot arm than a human?
It's three times as fast.
Okay. All right. Okay, wow. Hello, arm.
The AI can be taught into what you want it to take out. So before you implement this, you want to make sure you teach it, and then you'll pick out the things that's necessary.
Okay. Yeah. And it's basically a vacuum?
Yes.
It's like air?
It's suction.
Hello. Hi.
I'll just show you this individually. It can tell specifically only food packaging. So we tell the AI we only want this type of packaging, food packaging only. Any type of plastic is fine, just food packaging. So then it will only airflow food packaging stuff into our bin.
This facility handles recyclables from 5 cities around Taipei. And while AI improves sorting efficiency, one of its biggest flaws is that robot arms aren't as agile as human hands. So we still need real people in the end.
So this is the trash that came up from the conveyor belt from downstairs, right?
Yes,
okay.
Exactly. Yep.
And then what is this guy doing here?
Yeah, so sometimes when there's too much stuff coming, we don't want it to get jammed. So he's the person making sure nothing gets jammed up. And it's jammed, everything's down here, stop working.
Which is exactly what happened next.
The reason why it can happen a lot, so one of the big, one of the reasons is from the plastic bag.
Okay.
If the plastic, if there's too many of them, it gets like tangled within it, and then it gets, that's why we have to de-bell it.
Okay.
De-bell the plastic bag.
Oh. Don't stuff your trash bags too tight, guys. Yeah. Jam the machine. Okay, I've been holding on to all of my trash. Can I just like throw this out here?
Right. Let me see the trash.
Okay, I have onigiri, dripping. Just destroyed. Doujang bottle.
Okay. PET.
Okay.
All good. This one is good. But all these like these flexible little ones, these are gonna be treated as trash.
Okay.
You can just
throw this overboard.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. Bye. Okay.
Yep.
Roughly 95% of what's here is able to be recycled, so relatively little has to go to incinerators.
So basically, these are the plastic that was sorted, and then these will then go into another sorting facility that sort out specifically milk bottles for HDPE, and PP will be lunch boxes.
There's a five-way walk.
Wait, what, where?
This walk is
It just fell, I think.
Random casualties.
Wait, I think these are all walks.
Oh my god.
Yeah. You guys want a free walk?
Yeah. Let's take a free walk. I'm taking a free walk.
The effort to AI upgrade everything isn't just for the sorting facility. Dafon also wants to bring it to its regeneration plant, which is where all the good plastic goes to get a second chance at life, this time as pellets. And it's a family affair. This is Dafon's CEO, Matt Lin, who is Sandy's dad. This is where the bales of sorted plastic are cut, washed, and dried. In recycling, purity of material is the most important factor, so this stage is crucial. Then they're molded into pellets. This plant employs only 50 or so people, but the AI takeover isn't far in the future.
到目前, 还是大部分是人工，但是整个新的设备都测试完成之后，大概 reduce 了 90%，
就减了90%。哎呀，那你觉得这个是对这个人家的生命自己的 jobs
怎么办？It's the tough choice.
So how good is Taiwan at plastics recycling? A study showed that roughly 80% of imported and recycled plastic were used to make either finished products or pellets for export. Its recycling industry is larger than its domestic waste supply, so it actually imports plastic to be processed. But some say the metrics and good PR can be misleading.
Recycling means the material is being collected responsibly somehow, and then it's responsibly burned.
Arthur Huang is the CEO of MiniWiz, a Taiwanese company that converts waste materials into architectural fixtures.
Most people call that downcycling, and I call that actually just putting the particle into smaller particle into the air. Yeah.
Taiwan actually has one of the highest densities of waste incinerators in the world. And that's where most of the flimsier plastics, like bags and straw wrappers, have to be burned, since their quality is too low for recycling. Even if cities nail plastics recycling, there's another big pile to deal with.
我自己好像是没有减少，因为我觉得个人的努力好像比不过大公司或是他们的浪费。Good
news is, industrial waste is also cleaner, and there's a lot of it. Taiwan has a lot of big industry, in particular semiconductors and petrochemicals. So there's big potential for reuse there. That industry is exactly what makes its recycling infrastructure work. The country already has the industrial base to handle the manufacturing processes needed in recycling at scale.
What's the recycling system like where you live? Tell us in the comments below, and don't forget to click like and subscribe. See you next time.